still got room for it.
Turn to page 82, victory in Jesus. Amen. How many is glad that you got victory?
Amen. Amen.
Tonight you say, Mark, I know of someone that's sick, that's in the hospital, that needs a touch from God. That's you, and I ask you to lift up your hand. And if you're here tonight, you say, Mark, I know without a doubt I've got family that's lost that needs Jesus. That's you, I ask you to lift up your hand. Last but not least, if you're here tonight, you say, Mark, I've got something that only God knows about. I ask you to lift your hands tonight.
Leads deep into night. Sleeps Jesus save my soul.
Don't know why it happened. I'm not going to question why it happened. God didn't wish this on me. He didn't wish it on me, but He'll turn it into a blessing. I came right here to this church and I asked my brothers to anoint my hand and pray for me. I want you to look at it. I'm missing a finger. But there's no scar. I'm getting the use of that hand back. And it's getting better every day. Every day that hand gets better. Yeah. Yeah, glory to God.
He never promised that the cross would not get heavy and the hill would not be hard to climb.
You call my rage.
Come on. Yes. Come on.
You walk with me through fire.
Yes, right here.
And you heal.
Come on.
According to thy mercy, remember thou me. For thy goodness sake, O Lord. I'm captivated by what King David said at the beginning of verse 7. He said, remember not the sins of my youth. Now, and I'm going to try to convince him that that yoke was normal, that that yoke was just a part of life. And then if he gets comfortable with that yoke, then he'll wear it. And he won't pray for God to remove it from him because he'll believe it's just a part of life. And then one day I'll hook a burden to it. And then when he was called to praise God, he won't be able to praise God because he'll think, you, Caleb, he'll be packing around that burden. Oh, I'm going to break it down right where you are. See, that enemy will introduce drugs and perversion into the life of a young person. And he'll make them think it's just a part of life. Not showing them that when they're 40 and 50 years old, they're still going to be carrying that yoke. And they're going to be pulling something behind them they never wanted to pull. Talking, so many people don't believe God wants you blessed. They don't believe God wants you healed. Somebody said, are you a prosperity and health preacher? I said, well, I'm not a poverty and sickness preacher.
Amen.
He said, Barry, he said, God has just revealed to me that at a young age, somebody you love got choked on bubble gum. That's how real my God is. He said, at that moment, the enemy put a spirit of fear on you, and it's grown and grown and grown. But tonight, God is breaking that yoke of your life. He hit me. For 18 years, the church had said, well, that's just the way she is. She just bowed over. But when Jesus walked in, he said, that woman, hold on, be that way. Yeah. I'm preaching to some blood-bought saints tonight that are going through hell and struggling. Yeah. And everybody else is just like, oh, it's just the way you are. But God is in the house saying, you ain't got to be that way. Stuff I can't shake.